This program is brought to you by UCKG.
It's happening in every neighborhood. Down every street, sickness, addiction, and violence has been turning countless homes into crime scenes. Suffering, depressed, alone, suicidal.
Welcome to a program, Problems and Solutions. A very good evening. Do you know that there is a God that takes care of you? Many times you are there on the other side and perhaps you think that God doesn't take care of you, or because of the problems that you are going through, you even doubt about the existence of God. But I'm here to tell you that God takes care of you, and God has been seeing your suffering, your pain, your tears. And through this program, is giving to you an opportunity to change your life. That's why I would like to invite you for you to stay in these 50 minutes with us, only 50 minutes, and see how God transforms lives of people. Because God is not someone of the past. Miracles are not something of the past. God is still performing miracles today, because God is the same of yesterday, today, and forever. And if you want a miracle, my dear friend, and if you want to stop suffering, if you want to stop crying, in these 50 minutes, you're going to find the solution of your problem. It's only 50 minutes. You don't have nothing to lose to stay with us. And if in the meantime, you want to talk to someone, you have below your screen our telephone number. Let's see the miracles that God is performing.
Is really the answer for everything, you know, that I go through nowadays, and God is the one who gave this to me. Life is great. I'm very happy. You know, every day I have direction from God. Every day is different. There's challenges that I face, but there's always that guidance that comes from God. I believe it's been about 5 years that I started to really see a transformation inside of me. The first years of like being in the church, I was not taking my faith seriously. I'm focused mainly on changing things on the outside while like my inside was still the same. So I was very afraid of the unknown. As long as I like do what I need to do, it was that. But when it was something outside my comfort zone, where I needed to let go of, you know, a grudge that I have towards my dad, because I'm not really able to communicate with him, so I would not touch those parts inside of me. So that really would kind of make me to step back in my faith. It's been about 5 years that my life has truly transformed. When I first came, I saw that it was quite direct. I came on a Friday meeting and I kind of thought, this is not really for me. But I went home and I saw that like I still had all the problems that I was still going through. I found out about the Universal Church through my auntie, who used to attend with her husband, my uncle. And he was evangelized on the streets, and they were going through their own set of problems, and they started to see a result in their life. So they invited me and my brother, and at the time we were having family issues. Faith to me is this way to, you know, do that things that I couldn't do before, face difficulties, problems, and have direction from God. Faith is really the answer for everything, you know, that I go through nowadays, and God is the one who gave this to me. The things that I faced before, they were fear. I had lots of fear inside of me. It stemmed from my mom passing away, because that came as a shock. I always thought like things would get better. It was my way of escaping from the problems that were going on. When it actually happened, I was afraid of what will happen next. I was a very fearful person. I was depressed, you know, that led me to be sad, upset with myself. I would isolate myself a lot. I was just living quite numb, like ignoring everything that was going on around, because that was my way of dealing. Universal means to be one, united for me. And, you know, this makes me to even be more stronger, because I'm together with those who are in the same, you know, faith with me, and to serve the same purpose, you know, which is to serve God and reach out to all those who have not received this opportunity yet to know Him. So that's what it stands for me. The process for me to learn about faith was, first of all, coming to the meetings and you know, listening what was said and applying it. So I got to know about the chain of prayer. I got to know about, you know, the new purposes that were coming up, and I could use those to tackle the problems that I was going through. So that's when I started to really notice a difference, because I saw that from that moment on, God started to guide me. Today, I see myself as a strong and confident person. Compared to before, I was very insecure. I would find myself in a situation and I would find a way to avoid it. But today I'm able to face it because I know who is with me, you know, having this assurance that God is going to guide me through it. I'm able to face that and you know, become even more stronger through my faith. Today I have a blessed job where I'm able to serve God as well. It allows me to also spend time with my family and do things in the correct way. You know, through my faith, I learned to live a disciplined life. In my future is in God's hands. So that brings me peace. That brings me, you know, certainty. I have no regrets to be in the Universal Church, because this is where I found the solution for everything that I was going through. The person that I am is because of the Universal Church. There is no other place that I found the help that I found here. I always had a word from God of what I needed to do about it. For me, that is very precious. So the Universal Church is a place where I can go to and be at peace and have, you know, the guidance from God.
10 reasons to take part in the love therapy. 10. Overcome traumas.
The love therapy helped me overcome, you know, my traumatic experiences internally. When it came to my hatred, you know, against women, he taught me to have a clean heart and really take the dirt out that's inside of me.
9. Understand boundaries.
He helped me overcome my issues with, for example, being unfaithful to one person and not understanding the value of women. He helped me to see that women are not just objects. He helped me to understand the importance of marriage.
8. Learn to value yourself.
Valuing myself, becoming more confident, bold, bettering my relationships with those who are around me. And today I no longer have that mentality of being afraid of getting involved when it comes to my love life.
7. Learn about intelligent love.
The more I came, the more I wanted to learn more about myself and how I could make an impact in my love life, since I wanted to change.
6. Use reason over emotion.
Work on myself, it would improve my self-esteem and make me believe in myself. And as I come and I apply everything that I learn in the love therapy, I'm able to see results and be more confident that when I get into a relationship, I'll be able to succeed.
5. Better relationships with others.
The love therapy helped me overcome issues by allowing me to become more confident within myself, knowing my value, knowing who I am. And I was able to learn things that I can be able to teach my family. And I was able to express it to my family so we can have a good relationship with my family.
4. Prepare yourself before dating.
You come to the love therapy and it's actually a mirror, like, oh, I still need to work on making sure that I tell the truth all the time. I still need to work on making sure that I'm removing the things that aren't good in my life, for example. And I still have to, you know, make sure that I'm working on my character daily, because then that way I'm priming myself for when the perfect partner comes along.
3. Become a better husband and wife.
So, for example, if they're going through a situation or a problem, the love therapy helped them to understand, okay, this problem can be resolved in this way. It's not all just about, you know, your love life, but it's also about you on the inside, for you to unravel those things that's within yourself so that you know how to improve and to be better.
2. Believe in love.
Now I have that love for myself first. And I think that's going to always be the biggest thing, is having that comfort in myself and knowing that I'm good on my own. Like, the thing is, if I'm good on my own, am I complete on my own, then I'm going to be good with somebody else as well.
1. Bulletproof your relationship.
I learned how to build a good relationship with him, how to have a happy marriage.
The love therapy.
You know that when the life of the person changed, that person is a completely different person. And you know, my dear friend, what happened in these people's lives can happen in yours as well. Doesn't matter what you are going through and doesn't matter your problem. Imagine God inside of you, the presence of God, the God of the Father, the God of the Son, and the God of the Holy Spirit. This is what actually happened in these stories that you saw tonight. And God wants to do the same in your life. That's why we are inviting you to join one of our prayers at the Universal Church. We are open every single day. We have our main headquarters here in Stockholm. Also, we have our special services of Stop Suffering in either in Malmo or Göteborg. And you can come, you can join your faith with ours. And surely that as these people overcome, you overcame. You will overcome as well. So if you want more information about us, you can visit our website, www.uckg.se. Tomorrow, Thursday, is a day that we pray for the family and we pray for the love life. We are making this seminar of the changing, of the self-reconstruction. If you are suffering, especially in the love life, if you have been carrying inside of you luggage, you know, emptiness, sadness, issues of your past, you notice that the same problems that are happening with you happen with your mother, happen with your grandmother. You notice that there is a generation curse in your life. So give your step of faith and join us and learn through the Word of God how can you get rid of your problem and find the blessing in your love life. Our address is Birgiasgotan 106. We are very close to the Tunnelbana Tekniska. Our service tomorrow is going to be at 7 p.m., but the doors of the Universal Church are open every day. Give your step of faith and surely that something extraordinary is going to take place. It was a pleasure to be with you. Tomorrow we're going to be back with another program, Problems and Solutions.
This is your UCKG timetable, helping you to make a new beginning. Mondays, a meeting focused on achieving more in your financial life. Tuesdays, prayers for healing. Wednesdays, a meeting teaching you to develop in your spiritual life. Thursdays, a special prayer for the family. Friday, a service for your spiritual deliverance. Sundays, reconnect with God, the main meeting for your spiritual strength.
I'm not leaving this hospital until I know what's wrong with my daughter.
If you want out, that's fine with me.
This program is brought to you by UCKG.